Where is this? Like, the Plano community?
It's live right now.
I know what we're doing. Which
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, bismillahir rahmanir rahim, nahmaduhu wa salli ala rasulihil kareem, amma ba'd. First and foremost, I just want to give a shout out to my little friend Tawseef. May Allah bless him, may Allah put him with khair and afia. MashaAllah, he provided a good iftar for us. May Allah always keep him full and his family full. Before I start, I want to have a quick 1 minute reminder with a friend of mine. Come here. We're not really social distancing, but let me see this. All right, go ahead. Imam Nadeem, give us a quick one hadith, one reminder for this night. What we should do later, Khadr, come.
So I just want to just remind everyone that a lot of times we hear in khutbas and durus and halaqas that the night of Laylatul Qadr is equivalent to 1,000 months. That's wrong. Khayrun min alfi shahr is better than 1,000 months. That means that if we can make ibadah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on this night, Allah will not limit that at 1,000 months. Allah will begin inshallah from 1,000 months. And it's just going to go upwards inshallah. And once again, we read these ahadith. Man qama Ramadan iman ihtisaban ghufr lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbi. Whoever fasts in the month of Ramadan, Allah will forgive their sins. Man qama Ramadan, whoever stands for Ramadan in the month of Ramadan, Allah will forgive their sins. Also, man qama Laylatul Qadr, whoever stands on the night of Laylatul Qadr. So there's a very big chance that this could also be the night of Laylatul Qadr. Utilize this time, brothers and sisters. Make dua for me, make dua for your families, make dua for everyone, make dua for the entire Muslim Ummah. Despite COVID, a lot of our Muslim brothers and sisters are still going through a lot of challenges. There are a lot of Muslim brothers and sisters, brothers who are managing families, they have lost their jobs. Make dua for them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help them. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that on nights like these, we have today, we have inshallah three more opportunities after this, the 25th, 27th, 29th. And there are riwayat that are mentioned across the board, different sahaba, their opinions. Some say that it's on the 21st night, some say 23rd night, some say it's on 25th night. There is an explicit hadith that where the Prophet says that there's a very big chance that it can happen on the 27th, but it's from the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that it could be on any of these five nights. So this is why, let's try to exert ourselves. And this is, by the way, subhanAllah, this is Allah, you know, opening the vault for us. Just want to give you a quick one example. Imagine if the local bank had ever said to you that the bank is open, come and take whatever you want. If a person was sitting at home and said, you know what, I'm going to chill at home, and I'll go back, I'll go after like 1 hour, I'll go after like, you know, 2 hours, then you are a foolish person. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has opened up his bank. Come and take whatever you want. Take as much as you want. Now if we sit behind and we don't do anything, then we are the ones who are the losers. We are the ones who are losers. It's not Allah. I'll finish on this by saying, Allah is so giving, brothers and sisters. Allah is so giving. Anyone who recites 3 times in the morning and 3 times in the evening, رَضِيتُ بِاللَّهِ رَبًّا وَبِالْإِسْلَامِ دِينًا وَبِمُحَمَّدٍ نَبِيًّا. This is a Hassan Hadith. Anyone who says, I am pleased with Allah as being my Rabb, with Islam being my my code of life, my religion, and Muhammad being my Nabi, anyone who recites this 3 times morning and evening, the Prophet says, كَانَ حَقًّا عَلَى اللَّهِ. It is upon Allah, meaning that it is the responsibility and duty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and يُرْضِيَهُ يَوْمُ الْقِيَامَةِ to please this person on the day of judgment. Think about that. Allah has to please you on the day of judgment just because I said رَضِيْتُ بِاللَّهِ رَبًّا وَبِالْإِسْلَامِ دِينًا وَبِمُحَمَّدٍ نَبِيًّا 3 times. Throughout the day, it probably just take 10 seconds. But Allah is saying, the Prophet ﷺ is saying, Allah's responsibility is towards you to please you on the day of judgment. There are so many endless opportunities from Allah. If we don't take, we have no one to blame ourselves. We have no one to blame but ourselves on the day of judgment. Jazakumullah khair.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Jazakallah khair. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Ahmadu wa salli ala rasulil kareem. Amma ba'd. I actually had like 8 imams over. So they were having iftar and they were chilling, and it was the first time many of them got a chance to come and chill. So alhamdulillah, with decent social distancing, we had it done. And that is why their right and their haq upon me was that I delay my lesson for them. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Ahmaduhu wa salli ala rasulil kareem. Amma ba'd. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Yasin mentions the story of 3 messengers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that I sent 3 messengers to a city. And this was between the time of Isa alayhi salam and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi salam. They were not actual prophets, but they were just messengers who were disciples and who would promote the message. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that we sent the first messenger, then we sent the second one. وَعَزَزْنَاهُمْ بِثَالِثٍ فَقَالُوا إِنَّا إِلَيْكُمْ مُرْسَلُونَ That we are the messengers towards you. But people didn't believe them. People denied them, they belied them, they ignored them. Imagine that someone is trying to remind someone, be a better person. Listen, stop lying, stop being abusive, stop sexually abusing, stop harassing people, stop doing domestic violence, stop disrespecting your parents, stop looting other people, stop oppressing other people. And then a person says that, and a whole city is corrupt, and the entire city is like, nah bro, like, let us do what we want. The richest want to get richer, the poor must get poorer. We don't care about individuals. And you see, this is a desi mentality in us. If I own a restaurant, then the guy who works in my restaurant, the chef who works in my restaurant, must remain a chef for the rest of his life. He must remain a worker for the rest of his life. If he goes and he opens another store, all of a sudden our heart breaks. Oh my God, this person is doing competition with me. Do we not know that Allah is Razzaq? Allah is the one who sustains, Allah is the one who maintains, and Allah is the one who gives. When we doubt that someone else opening shop will infringe on our rizq and infringe on what we will get and on our income, then that means we are doubting the treasures of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the destiny that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has set for you and I. So going on this, I remembered one incident that in Muslim Spain, there was a person who came to buy some merchandise. When he came to the store, the person says, look, my brother, you know when you are in a tourist city like Istanbul, Karachi, London, New York, you're going to find like a bunch of souvenirs. And everybody's got the same souvenir. Some sell it high, some sell it low. I was in Beijing, China one time. So I was walking and there was this handcrafted bag. With yarns. And the first lady I met, she was like, look, you're not going to find a price better than this. This is worth 600 yen. You know, this is handmade. This is quality stuff. I was mind blown. I paid it immediately. I was still a fresh traveler in those days. After that, I walked through Tiananmen Square. And for the next 50 people, by the time I got to the last individual, the last person was selling it for 25. The last individual was selling for 25. The first one, because they were able to loot the foolish travelers that came and the tourists that came. I got fooled with them as well. So in Muslim Spain, the same scenario existed where there were individuals and there were people that were selling objects. So a person stops and a tourist stops and he says, can I buy something from you, right? For example, like a pen. Can I buy this pen? The person says, look, man, this pen, you're going to find the exact same pen 6 stores down and go buy it from him. It's the exact same price. So the person said, brother, I'm here giving you business, but you're turning me away and sending to another individual. He says, that is also my brother, not blood brother, biological, but he's also my Muslim brother. And I have made few sales since the morning and times are difficult. And I was noticing that nobody walked into his store since morning. He also has a wife and children and a family. And he also has people to provide for. Maybe if you go and buy from him, Allah will put barakat and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help him and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will assist him. So in the same manner, Allah says, وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ قَوْلًا مِمَّنْ دَعَى إِلَى اللَّهِ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا وَقَالَ إِنَّنِي مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ The best of individuals are the ones who promote the message of Allah, but then they're humble about it. They don't take any credit. They don't take any single person's credit. They just want to be humble and they just want to help other people out. So Allah says, وَعَزَّزَنَاهُمْ بِثَالِثٍ And we gave them a third person to support. فَقَالُوا إِنَّا إِلَيْكُمْ مُرْسَلُونَ That we are prophets to you. قالوا ما أنتم إلا بشر مثلنا وما أنزل الرحمن من شيء إن أنتم إلا في ضلال مبين. They said, no, you're not a messenger. You're lying. You're capping, bro. You know what the hell you're talking about. You guys are lost. Yeah, you guys are backwards. Like, you pray, bro. You go to God. God doesn't exist. Science is everything. Oh, yeah, science is everything. Science that cannot explain how this virus is spreading, the way it's spreading, what it's doing. So everything that science has said, how a virus operates, this is the complete opposite of it. That a virus that they've never seen before has erupted. And Allah has humbled their science. Allah has humbled their economics. Allah has humbled their society. And Allah has shown Limanil Mulkul Yawm, who is the one who holds superior dominion over all and over every single individual. So then this one person, وَجَاءَ مِنْ أَقْسَى الْمَدِينَةِ رَجُلٌ يَسْعَى قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ اتَّبِعُوا الْمُرْسَلِينَ There was a person that was coming from the outskirts of the city. He was far away. He wasn't wealthy. He wasn't rich. He didn't live in downtown, but he lived in a far off area. وَجَاءَ رَجُلٌ مِنْ أَقْصَى الْمَدِينَةِ From the corner of the town. He couldn't afford the main area to live in. He used to live far away in such an area where the homes were very, very cheap.
And he came, but just because he was far away, he didn't just take his time. Allah captures the entire man, where he was coming from and how he was coming. Allah says, وَجَاءَ رَجُلٌ مِنْ أَقْصَى الْمَدِينَةِ. He came from the outskirts, يَسْعَى, but he was running. Like Allah's, imagine Allah, the great Allah, is talking about a man. Allah says, رَجُلٌ. رَجُلٌ means someone insignificant. Someone who has no superiority, someone who has no clout, someone who has a menial job, someone that nobody turns towards. Allah says, وَجَاءَ رَجُلٌ مِنْ أَقْصَى الْمَدِينَةِ. A man came from the outskirts. Yes, qala ya layta qawmi ya'lam. He says that ittabi'u man la yas'alukum ajran wa hum muhtadun. He says, follow these people. Listen to them. Listen to something good. It's gonna benefit you. And they said to him, shut up. Shut up. If you don't stay quiet, we're gonna stone you. We're gonna kill you. We're gonna beat you. And he says, wama liya la a'budu alladhi fatarani wa ilayhi turja'un. Attakhidhu min dunihi aliya. وَإِيُّرُدْنِ الرَّحْمَنُ بِضُرِّ لَا تُغْنِي عَنِّي شَفَاعَةٌ شَيْئًا وَلَا يُنْقِذُونَ إِنِّي إِذًا لَفِي ضَلَالٍ مُبِينٍ إِنِّي آمَنْتُ بِرَبِّكُمْ فَاسْمَعُونَ. So they started arguing and debating. Then this man, he had white spots all over him. He never got married. He never enjoyed the embrace of a woman. He never got his first kiss. Never got his first hug. Nobody slided into his DM. He never had any affection. Never filled his stomach 2 times a day. The man stayed hungry. The man was struggling. And finally he says, إِنِّي أَمَنْتُ بِرَبِّكُمْ فَاسْمَعُونَ. I have believed in Allah. When he said that, they beat him to death and he died. Then when that happened, Allah, either this conversation is happening in the future, but Allah is telling us now. The conversations of the future, but Allah is telling us now. Or that Allah sent him to a metaphorical Jannah, a metaphorical paradise or barzakhi paradise. So Allah says, قِيلَ دَخُلِ الْجَنَّةِ. Enter Jannah. Jannah is yours. So now when he enters Jannah, he didn't ask for the khuds of Jannah. He didn't ask for the palace of Jannah. He didn't ask for the wine of Jannah. He didn't ask for the water of Jannah, the gold of Jannah, the fruits of Jannah, the treasures of Jannah. And Jannah is a place that anything you ask, Allah will give it to you. It's yours. The first thing he says when he enters Jannah is قَالَ يَا لَيْتَ قَوْمِي يَعْلَمُونَ بِمَا غَفَرَ لِي رَبِّي وَجَعَلَنِي مِنَ الْمُكْرَمِينَ. He says, oh, I wish my people knew how my Allah forgave me. I wish they knew the mercy that my Allah had on me. And Allah says, oh, Habeeb Najjar, this is Jannah. If you want something, we make it happen. So Allah seals this story in Surah Yasin and places it in our Quran for all of us to read. The moment he asks something, Allah said, it's done. You want them to know? What does he want? Just tell them, بِمَا غَفَرَ لِي رَبِّي وَجَعَلَنِي مِنَ الْمُكْرَمِينَ. How my Allah forgave me and how my Allah gave me honor. Today we think we don't have clout. Today we think we have no followers. Today we think we have nobody. Let me tell you something. After a certain amount of followers, you have no idea who the heck is following you. You have no idea. You can't even keep up. It no longer impresses you. Then it's just the number going up. It doesn't matter. So then it shows how weak you are because you'll never be on top. There will always be somebody else on top. فَوْقَ كُلِّ ذِي عِلْمٍ عَلِيمٍ. There's going to be another individual on top. Leave only be an individual who wants good for people. What do we learn from this surah? That remember, remind other people of a message. Go and support the message. Support the mashayikh and the ulama and the scholars. Go share their video, share their posts. Go share their halaqas in classes. When the classes begin, share them. This man supported the messengers and the ulama, and Allah mentioned his story in the Quran. His love for the scholars and mashayikh, he dropped them. Umar, your word messed up my story. He respected and loved the ulama, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put his story inside the Quran. Allah placed it inside the Quran. Anyway, as this is falling into the 25th night of Ramadan, I want to give some advices on how a person can get forgiven by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, one of the ways to erupt Allah's rahmah is to reflect on how weak you are. And just to think to yourself how insignificant you are, but you get to talk to Allah. Like you get to speak to Allah. Like, do you realize, all of you that are on this call right now, how many times have you listened to a lecture throughout the year?
Today on the big night, how many Ramadan lectures have you made? But today Allah wanted you to sit here and listen to Him. That means before the creation was created, before a prophet was sent, before men were made and women were made and angels were made and jinns were made, on the tablet of Allah, when Allah was decreeing destiny, He wrote your name down. And He said on a big night of Laylatul Qadr, that could be Laylatul Qadr, these individuals are going to listen to a message of mine and a word of mine because I want them to come closer to me. You see, there is a love that Allah has with you. There are people who are more pious than you. There are people who are wealthier than you, healthier than you, but they may not be able to do worship or ibadah. I tell my youth today, you can do a sijda. Allah has given you the opportunity. One day go and see the elders who are trying. My mother, she just tells me, I wish to do a sijda, but when I do a sijda, my knees hurt too much. I can no longer do it. A time will come. You have less than 40 years to do sijda to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before your knees give up, before your back starts aching, before you can't stand the way you stand. If you can't worship Allah at your strongest, how will you worship Allah at your weakest? If you can't turn to Allah when your body can do anything, how will you worship Allah when your body can't do nothing? You will be lying down in a hospital bed, wishing and dying to pray 2 rak'at. But then you will remember the days of your youth where you missed so many salahs. Ya layta shababa ya'udu yawman fa ukhbiruhu bima fa'ala al-mashibu. I wish for one day my youth would come back. One day that my youth would come back so I could tell my youth what happened with my old age. I could tell them that the mistakes they made in their youth, I'm suffering now. I tell you all the time, the sins you do today, the zina you do today, the haram actions you do today, the wrong snaps you send today, that will be what you will be begging for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive you when you're on your deathbed. All of us, not just you, me, every one of us. The sins of our youth will be what we will cry rivers of tears in our old age. If Allah gives us old age, there are many who don't even reach old age and they die in their youth. We hear stories of people dying all the time. We said last year to people, what if we didn't get another Ramadan? We told people last year, what if we never got another, what if you didn't get another Ramadan? And people were like, yeah, you know, it's just, we hear it. But today Allah didn't give any one of us a Ramadan in the masjid. Illa mashaAllah. None of us got the Ramadan in the masjid. This is a historic reminder that if we don't turn to Allah, we can have $1 million masjid, $5 million masjid, $10 million masjid. But if Allah doesn't want us to enter it, then you can have all the doors and everything, but no one can enter. Is there any security outside the masjid? No. Is there any police? No. But no one can enter. What does this show you? That Allah is upset with us. Turn to Allah, beg for Allah's forgiveness. And also, do dua for me as well and my family as well. Inshallah, I'm going to do some dua for everyone. And then I'm going to do some special dua for some of the people that are watching live, inshallah.
Allahumma laka alhamdu kama yanbaghi li jalali wajhika wa azimi sultanik. اللهم إنا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا ولأولادنا ولأزواجنا ولمن له حق علينا يا رب العالمين اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا اللهم أجرنا من النار اللهم أجرنا من النار اللهم أجرنا من النار اللهم إنا نسألك من خير ما سألك منه نبيك وحبيبك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ونعوذ بك من شر ما استعاذك منه نبيك وحبيبك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم أنت المستعان وعليك البلاغ ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. Ya Allah, forgive our major and minor sins. Ya Allah, forgive the sins we did knowingly and unknowingly. Ya Allah, forgive the sins we did in Ramadan and the sins we did outside of Ramadan. Ya Allah, forgive the sins we did in your house, Ya Allah, and forgive the sins we did on the streets, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, forgive the sins we did in the darkness of our rooms and forgive the sins we did in the brightness of the day. Ya Allah, not a day goes by but we don't displease you. Ya Allah, not a day goes by that we don't turn away from you. Ya Allah, not a day goes by that we don't forget you. But Ya Allah, you never forgot us. You gave us breath, you gave us air to breathe, water to drink, food to eat, clothes to wear, and Ya Allah, family to love. But yet we have been ungrateful to your blessings. Ya Allah, the blessings you have given us, we've turned away. Ya Allah, you've given us more blessings than most of the world. Ya Allah, there are people who don't have these blessings. There are children who have nothing for iftar and nothing for suhoor, and their fast is made from just some water, some sips of water. Ya Allah, allow us to be grateful. Ya Allah, these are the blessed nights. Don't turn us away from you. Ya Allah, don't turn our hands away from you. Ya Allah, don't turn us away from you. Ya Allah, if you close your doors of mercy, we have no other door to go to. Ya Allah, we are begging you. Ya Allah, you love the beggars. Ya Allah, we are beggars in your court, Ya Allah. We are beggars in your court, Ya Allah. We don't know how to ask you dua. We don't know how to call upon you. We don't even know how to cry, Ya Allah. We don't even know how to cry, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, we're weak hearts. We're weak souls. Ya Allah, but you are great and aziz. Ya Allah, if you don't worship, if you don't forgive us, we will lose everything, Ya Allah. But if you forgive us, you lose nothing, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, you said that when my servant calls upon, I respond. Ya Allah, Ya Allah, we are calling upon you. As Imam Nadeem said, رَضِيتُ بِاللَّهِ رَبَّا وَبِالْإِسْلَامِ دِينَا وَبِمُحَمَّدِ النَّبِيَّا رَضِيتُ بِاللَّهِ رَبَّا وَبِالْإِسْلَامِ دِينَا وَبِمُحَمَّدِ النَّبِيَّا رَضِيتُ بِاللَّهِ رَبَّا وَبِالْإِسْلَامِ دِينَا وَبِمُحَمَّدِ النَّبِيَّا That whosoever recites this three times, then it is Allah's responsibility on the Day of Judgment to make that person happy. Ya Allah, we have all said it, Ya Allah. We have all recited it. رَضِيتُ بِاللَّهِ رَبَّا وَبِالْإِسْلَامِ دِينَا وَبِمُحَمَّدِ النَّبِيَّا رَضِيتُ بِاللَّهِ رَبَّا وَبِالْإِسْلَامِ دِينَا وبمحمد النبي رضيت بالله ربا وبالإسلام دينا وبمحمد النبي يا الله. We have made this dua to you. Now forgive us, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, the remainder days of Ramadan, allow them to be blessed and good. Ya Allah, cleanse our heart, Ya Allah. Cleanse our hearts, Ya Allah. Put nur in our hearts, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, make us love everyone, Ya Allah. Those who have oppressed us and harmed us, Ya Allah, forgive them as well. Ya Allah, rahm and karam upon them as well. Those who have loved us, Ya Allah, increase their love for us, Ya Allah. Subhana rabbika rabbil عزتي أما يصفون والسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. Inshallah, we'll make some special du'as for some of our friends here. All right, which friends of mine are here today for du'a? Maria, inshallah, make some dua for her. And we have Mahwish, we'll make dua for Mahwish and Maria. Mahwish, Maria, and Zuhair. Zuhair Ahmed, I think their last name is, from Austin. For Maria, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you all the happiness you are looking for. May Allah bless you. May Allah forgive you this Ramadan. May Allah allow your heart to be close to Him. May Allah fill it with nur. May Allah bless you with the love of Allah. May Allah make you addicted to His love. May Allah remove the love of the dunya from your heart. May Allah make you the way Dad wants to see you be. Mahwish, may Allah guide you, protect you, all the love you have for deen and studying. May Allah fill your heart with nur and love and muhabba for His deen. May Allah remove any negative qualities you may have. May Allah remove and suppress those negative qualities. May Allah give you motivation to cry in front of Him in your tahajjud and pray all your salawat and do dhikr to Allah and be connected with Him. And Zuhair Ahmed, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fill your life with barakah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fill your life with nur and happiness and success. May Allah give you all the best in the dunya and the akhirah. Jazakallah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.